Step 1. Inspect frame. Inspect the housing frame to ensure that tie-in plates are secured, studs are plumb, and wall is braced and free of any types of installation defects. Repair any issues before moving forward. Step 2. Preparation. Zip system panels can be installed both vertically and horizontally. It's acceptable to mix the sheathing orientation. Best practice is to make sure that the sheathing panels are tying the floor systems and the wall panels tightly to each other. Overlapping the panels all the way to the sill plate and rim joist will create a good rack and secure tie-downs for better strength and longevity. There are circles and squares on each zip system panel. The circles are for use with 16-inch on-center layouts, and the squares are for 24-inch on-center layouts. Nail into either the circles or the squares depending on stud layout. The dashed lines along the edges are used both as a reference for a tape seam and as an approximate spacing for a 6-inch on-center installation. Nail the panels 3/8 of an inch from the edge when nailing near the outer dotted lines. Place the nails 12 inches apart using the circles and the squares as a reference marker. For sheer strength and stability, it's recommended that you use a glue tip ring shank nail. Setting the nail gun depth and regulating the PSI of the compressor is crucial when installing zip system panels. Each driven nail head should be flush with the face of the sheathing. Overdriving nails into the zip system sheathing will pierce the weather-resistant barrier and can cause future moisture problems. Proper nail depth is extremely important. Step 3. Install sheathing. Start the installation process on the long axis, keeping the sheets tight to each other, top to bottom. Maintain an 1/8-inch gap when coupling the butt seams to account for panel expansion. Place the zip panel on the layout line and tack the sheathing off at the corners to make sure that they are represented properly on the studs. Measure to the proper spacing or use the shapes for 16-inch or 24-inch on-center spacing. Push or pull the stud to make sure that it's straight from top to bottom. When installing zip panels, use a minimum of 32-inch offset. 48-inch is preferred. This'll ensure that there aren't vertically stacked seams across the entire wall. Maintaining stair-stepped or stagger-stepped sheathing seams will give sheer strength to the wall. Step 4. Taping preparation. Once the sheathing is fastened, prep the seams for tape. Inspect all nail patterns, ensuring they're set right before you move forward with the process. Wipe down the seam areas with a dry rag or use a blower to remove all sawdust, dirt, and water before applying flashing tape to the sheathing seams. Step 5. Tape seams. Ensure that the tape is centered over the seams within plus or minus 1/2 inch to provide adequate coverage. Wherever tape splices occur at a horizontal or vertical seam, create an overlapping splice of at least 3 inches. At T-joints, the tape pieces should overlap by at least 1 inch. When taping inside joints, it's helpful to fold the tape vertically before applying to ensure the tape fully reaches the inside corner seam. Tape over any areas of the panel that are damaged during construction, including overdriven nails. Use the Zip J roller to apply pressure to the tape and smooth out any wrinkles. This will also emboss all seams with a Z pattern, making inspection for proper seam sealing easier. Step 6. Wall penetrations. Install doors, windows, and any other wall penetration. Seal all penetrations and flanges with zip tape or zip stretch tape. Step 7. Finishing. Once all door and windows are installed and all wall penetrations are flashed, install all trims and cladding. This demonstration is intended for professionals only. Homeowners should not attempt these projects without first consulting a licensed professional.